Okay, I have to admit that was completely unexpected. I mean, this is Riboku we're talking about, a guy who's a chess master who's known to do many ruthless and if not also a bit underhanded techniques. And he just did this? It almost feels like an improvisation, but I know it was not an improvisation. It was just something that... I mean, did Olsen seriously not predict this? I mean, granted, we did not predict this either. I'm still just a little bit shocked it happened. It's almost like you wanting to... well, we'll get to that in when we go into details. Yes, this is me, the angry enemy fan, and yes, this is The Kingdom, chapter 530. So what special thing happened? Well, if I'm gonna spoil the ending, Riboku just appeared and killed Makoko. I'm saying just appeared because he appeared in the just in the ending. After everything that has happened, after Shin and Moten each getting on the side and seems to corner Kisu, for some strange reason, Riboku just shows up seemingly out of nowhere and just one-shots Mako. I know that I hate the guy and I do not like Mako, but I still suspect felt that was kind of a... what the hell? But what happened in the chapter itself? Well, Shin rides with his fastest ones, and in order to do that, they need to, of course, break right through. But now they need to reach this, because if they do well, Shin will become a general. Oh yeah, and Naki is actually on this riding crew. That was good. Of course, Kisu sees that it is the Hishin unit. I've long predicted, or at least said, that shouldn't Bate or Kisu react with emotion when they saw Shin? Turns out I was wrong. In a way, they were not the ones who reacted with emotion. Apparently, Ryuto's elite guard were the one who reacted with emotion. Of course, that couldn't stop the flying arrow that is the Hishin unit. But it's very, but it's also very clear that Kisu is not underestimating them. He is acknowledging that despite the fact not only did they kill Ryuto, but after all, they did take the head of... well, or at least killed Kisha too. And apparently, he misjudged them back then. What, you misjudged them? Oh, Kisu, you seemingly seems to be a humble man, but in the end, you are also a little bit arrogant if you think you couldn't have done, make them. So, he thinks they should fall into a defensive line. But that does not exactly happen. So the units, one unit rides out, which is the elite honor guards of Ryoto, which is apparently 200 men. They, with their bloodthirsty eyes, says that they intend to kill, of course, Hishin unit. Elsewhere, Bate is struggling against Mako's troops. Also arrogantly believe that he cannot believe that all of these, well... have that Mako have actually put the training through all of this. Oh, Bate, you arrogant man, you also need to die. So, I mean, I'm actually more surprised the fact that he is not the one riding right against Hishin unit. I mean, he hears that they're riding here, but he's not getting an order. Instead, he only wishes luck for the unit who's gonna take care of the Hishin unit, as it says, to adopt a brother in heaven to watch over them. Of course, they cannot stop the raging blade of the Hishin unit, which I described as a flying arrow. Many of them recognize Kyokai, but Kyokai, with a newfound resolve, kills them all. Almost also showing a little bit guilt in... either she's showing, or maybe she's showing a little bit guilt. I mean, after all, she had no choice to kill Ryuto. In war, there is no time for sympathy stories. But she definitely did not like what Kanki did to all the other people. So there are many things she would have rather gone the other way. Still, this is war, so she has stronger the her resolve, and she is actually stronger than ever. Elsewhere, Moten hears the fact that the Heishin unit has broken past, and is surprised that General Osen do that. So it seems in the end, Moten and Shin is gonna compete on who gets to the top first. Down on the ground, Mako mentions that about all of this. But according to him, all of this is just some shallow. He describes it as a battle is about a flow in which it develops, and a strategy where one element can morph into one capable of delivering a decisive blow. Is there any more scenario more terrifying than that for the enemy? Which is basically this, an overwhelming force which clouds the judgments. However, he also arrogantly believed that he is the true star on this battlefield. I guess he had that ending to him coming. And he is right. Kisu is definitely struggling and wanting to do what they should do, heading towards the headquarters, everything more. And in the end, he sees the Heishin unit reaching the hill. So, and the same can be said with the Moten unit also raising them. So yeah, in the end, it's now the it almost looks like Kisu really cannot run away because he has two different troops now surrounding him. Still, we shouldn't underestimate just how many tricks can happen. One general says, if you run and abandon the HQ, the Battle Army Real will be completely defenseless. They will be at Shin's mercy. Sorry, if we are to withdraw, then at best time as the Battle Army. So, but Kisu decides that they're not going to abandon the HQ. Instead, they're going to focus all of the resources on stopping the Heishin unit. For him, they are more that they are the more threat. And then he mentions to everyone else that although it has seemed that he had been a little bit overwhelmed by all this, which he was, he has in the end seen that they're not the only ones who have been in great danger. Because while Orson has a sharp vigil, maybe it is very likely that he sensed this with his intuition. Because in the end, the chapter ends where seemingly out of nowhere, as I said before, Riboku, with a guard of his guards, appear and pierce Makugo's throat before he even can react, therefore cutting Osen in the more disadvantaged stage. After all, Makugo was one of his hands. Who was he? The right or the left? You don't have to correct me, unless you don't want to. But yeah, I mean, Riboku is a guy who always lies that he's never on a battlefield, and we know he is on a battlefield. He's just a liar. So for him to appear like that, that was actually kind of ballsy. And as I said before, it seems so out of character for someone like Riboku. But that's maybe just me. After all, this is a war where Zhao cannot be allowed to lose. And he just killed Mako. There is no way Orson is not going to take that without a shock. Or maybe he anticipated that. After all, we cannot forget that Orson is a guy that throws away everything that is useless to him and takes in everything that is useful to him. Makugo in this situation were useless to him. Heishin unit and Moten has not yet fallen. But if this ends with Kisu getting away, although Kisu does say that they're not going to abandon their HQ. In the end, should we say this is a loss and loss situation? But in the end, I think the real sufferer for the war right now is Shin, China, having lost one of their general, which is also one of Orson's right-hand or left-hand men. So yeah, that was unexpected. Very unexpected. And Riboku is now in the army's territory, but I don't think any of them realized that. Wouldn't that be amazing if Shin just realized that and just suddenly charged right there towards Riboku? Nah, there's no way that's gonna happen. But you give me your thoughts if you have any.